communication. Let us see exactly how the communication process continues. Objective of this session. At the end of this session, you will be able to explain the nature of communication process. If we see the nature of communication process, we can see several steps. A person experiences many things in an environment. An idea, thought, or feeling comes to a person's mind. The person needs to share his or her idea, thought, or feeling with someone. Environment is analyzed and channel is selected. Symbolic system familiar to the receiver is selected. The message is given a specific form by using the selected channel and symbols. Receiver perceives the message by using his or her previous experiences. The message is interpreted by the receiver. Response needs to be given. Feedback may be given by using different system of symbols. And the communication process ends here. A person experiences many things in an environment. There are many examples, many experiences which we keep on getting every time in our life. Sometimes we go out, visit some places, and then we feel like sharing about these experiences. Sometimes we also get some cultural experiences. Say, dance or song from different culture, meeting different people in the world. Sometimes we experience new things with new machines. A person who explores something new on computer also likes to share what she did, what she explored by using computer or new tools. Sometimes we also see and exchange our ideas with our friends. So what all we learned together, what all we discussed together, what all we explored together is worth sharing. Many a times, even in our class, teacher teaches us and we get new knowledge, new information, new experience. Our environment is full of such new informations, new experiences, different experiences. Sometimes those are similar to our previous experiences, or sometimes those are totally different. In both the cases, we feel the need of sharing all these experiences and communication begins. The second step is an idea, thought, or feeling comes to a person's mind. Many a times we have discussed and we see that communication is initiated for sharing of some ideas, new thoughts, information, feelings. And then, because of this need, communication process starts. So as to share these feelings and thoughts and ideas, the sender analyzes environment. Depending on the nature of the environment, channel is selected. The channel can be on the basis of the need of the environment, on the basis of the nature of content, and even depending on likes and dislikes, interests and skills of the sender. If sender is very creative and if performing art is the channel, then either the sender will show or convey message through dance, through singing, through paintings. If a teacher wants learners to read something interesting, then the teacher may come out with a beautiful handbook or a storybook, or some authors may write some different books. Some cartoon strips can be used as a channel. If we are talking to children, our channel will be different. If we are talking or trying to communicate with adults, our channel will be different. After the channel is selected, according to the need of the environment and depending on the nature of the learners and content, some symbolic system familiar to the receiver is selected. We always see that because learners or receivers are the ones who will perceive the message, symbolic system familiar to them is very important. The sender can communicate only if the sender is familiar with symbolic system of the receiver. Or maybe the sender can change some system and come out with such a system where language may not be the barrier. Illustrations, pictures, symbols may work as message giving channels. Once this message is conveyed through a particular symbolic system, the message passes through some channel. For this, using those symbols, some new form to the message need to be given by the sender. The sender prepares this message, develops this message. So, a particular form is generated. Now, this form can be a speech. The form can be a combination of visuals and the sender's speech. The form can be a poem. The form can be a drama. The form can be a picture. Receiver perceives this message by using his or her own experiences. Now, these are previous experiences of the receiver which help receiver to perceive the message. If nothing is relevant, nothing is related from the previous experiences of receiver, it becomes very difficult for the receiver to understand the message, to perceive the message. That's why we say that the teacher should always refer to learner's environment, should try to link new knowledge with the previous knowledge. Teacher should always ask or deliver examples from learners' lives and relate new content with the old content. Once receiver perceives the message is interpreted. Whatever way, whatever effective manner sender uses, it's up to receiver what interpretation of the message is done at receiver's end. Remember, the message is not the one which is sent by the sender, but message is the one which is perceived and interpreted by the receiver. So many a times, message sent by the sender and message interpreted by the receiver may differ. Communication process fails there. So it is very important that the message is interpreted by the receiver in the same manner which is intended by the sender. Whether the message is interpreted in right or wrong manner will be clearer once receiver gives response. It's not only to find out whether the message is interpreted correctly or not, but response is essential to continue the communication. The communication cycle is complete only after receiving response from the receiver. So even teachers should always keep the channel of feedback open. Learners should always be encouraged to give response to the teacher. Many a times, if teachers plan effectively, learners become senders and teacher becomes feedback giver or responder. Feedback may be given by using different system of symbols. It is not at all essential that the feedback should be given using the same system of symbols. The sender may give some gift or some object to the receiver, and receiver may just pass on some verbal message. Sender may scold loudly, the receiver may start crying. So, different symbols, different channels are always used or can be used for imparting feedback. The most important thing is both senders and receivers should understand and interpret the symbol system effectively, and continuation of communication is essential in the communication process.